I think the world today is facing catastrophic challenges, which are of 360 dimension. And therefore, the thinking, the linear thinking is archaic. You need to do as a leader to have a 360 degree of thinking, because everything is interconnected. I stop there.
And how do we get there?
We do that to understand that the global problem are interconnected as envisaged in SDGs. When you talk about terrestrial, you're talking also about the oceans, you're talking about the sky. You're looking at the challenges that are impacting us from different angles, from the environmental, economic, and social. And when you dissect these issues, you find that it's a 360 degree challenge you have, and therefore you have to have a bit of information everywhere so that your managerial or leadership solution can see that angle in order to have a sustainable solution.
Just to echo what the previous speakers have said, the first issue is, are they all leaders? Or are they maintenance managers? I would argue the persons holding these positions are maintenance managers, and because of that, they want to maintain the status quo. And anything that is evaluative, which leads to unpredictability, and could change the status quo, is going to be perceived with fear. The few who are leaders do not have enough of a critical mass to bring in evaluative thinking to make a cultural change. And this is something that has been with us from time immemorial. It's implicit, and the psychological element is this evaluation also carries with it a badge of potential change. And we could argue on independence or interconnectedness or whichever way you wish. We all know when we start an evaluation, everyone is welcoming. When you present the results, what happens? Things change. And the same is going to happen with the SDGs on a much more global scale. So we're in this, it's complex. We need to understand political, psychological, managerial dimension, and of course, there's a huge political undercurrent in the whole question of the SDG, which is not spoken about.
My experience with the, you're welcomed with the results, as long as they're positive, and with the negative, your methods really are terrible. They really suck. You just really are not a good methodologist with the results. Stefan.
Yes, so maybe I will elaborate and build up on the presentation I did. I think leaders and politicians are, of course, essentially doers rather than people who reflect. And probably we as evaluators, we are much more used to, you know, reflecting and to even to the falsifying principles, right? So we are there to try to disprove theories rather than confirm theories. Whereas actually the politicians want to confirm that they are in the right direction, because otherwise they couldn't, you know, move on. And I think, you know, it's important to have a dialectical kind of conversation between evaluators and leaders. And I think that the number one barrier is what I said in my intervention. I think it is the fear and the threat that there is around evaluative thinking and critical thinking in the form of evaluation. So I think we can support leaders to be better at reflecting, and I do believe that the 2030 leader will be an evaluative thinker if we want to change the world.
Okay,